Hello everyone, hope you all are doing good. My name is Rahul Jangra. So in this video, we'll be learning about functions in Python. So first, we need to understand the meaning of function. So basically, a function is block of code which only runs when it is called. Okay, so in the function, you can pass the data that is known as the parameters into a function, and function can return data as a result. So basically, in the function, you need to pass the data, and when you will be calling that function, it will return, it will give you the output, it will give you the data as output. Okay, so a function is a block of code that performs a task. It can be called and reused multiple times. There is nothing like that you can create a function and you can use that function only for once. You can use that function and you can call that function multiple times. So basically, you can pass information to a function and it can send information back. Many programming languages have built-in functions that you can access in their libraries, but you can also create your own function. That I will explain you in this video, that how to use the built-in function that are available in the library and how you can create your own function as well. Okay, so these are the types of functions. Built-in functions we have, functions in module, user-defined functions. So built-in functions are those functions which are available in the library. You can use, and these are ready to use. Okay, so you do not need to define anything for these functions. These are already available in the library. You can easily use them. For example, we have lan function, type function, and input function. So lan function is basically to check the length of the word, or to length of any word, you can say. Okay, for example, if I type my name Rahul in a cell and if I want to check the length, the number of alphabet, basically if I want to check the number of alphabets in my name, I can use this function lan and then parentheses. Inside the parentheses, I can give my name. Okay, lan, inside the parentheses, Rahul I can give. Okay, so it will return you the number of alphabets in my name. It will return you the output as 5, R-A-H-U-L, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, then type function is basically for to know about the type of the data. Okay, like it is an integer type or it is a string type, it will give you the output as. Or input function is here to accept the input from the user. Then we have function in module. These are basically the mathematically functions which are already available in the library, like built-in function. Then third, we have user-defined function. In this, we need to define the function. We need to call that function. Okay. So first, we learn that how to use the built-in functions here. So built-in functions are part of Python language. These are functions readily available to use. Okay. For example, we have max function, that is maximum minimum input function we have. So basically, max function we can use and it will return you the largest item in an iterable. Iterable here means a sequence. If I have a list, okay, if I define a list in a cell, okay, like that list contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay. So I can use the max function for that. To know the largest item available in that iterable or available in that sequence or list. Okay, so it will return you the value 5 that is available in your list. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the maximum, the largest one is 5. The minimum will return you the smallest item in an iterable, and input function you can use to accept the input from the user. Now we have functions of module. Basically the mathematical function. So to use this function, first we have to import the library. The library name is math module. We can import by typing import space math. Okay, and after that we can use this function like print. Inside the parentheses we can define that what we want to print. Okay, math dot square root of 0. So to know about the square root of 0, we can type it like this. Okay, if you want to know about the square root of 4, you can do any kind of number. Okay, if you want to know the square root of 9, you can type 9 here or anything. So now we have the most important, how to define a function. these are concerned under the user defined function, where you need to define the function and to call the function. So basically, to define the function, we use the keyword def. Okay, so this is basically for the function definition. It must be followed by the function name and the parentheses list of formal parameters. The statement that form the body of a function start at the next line and must be indented. Okay, I'll tell you about this. So the function header, that begin with def and end with semicolon. So this semicolon we use here to fit to indent. Okay, then we give the parameters variable that are listed within the parentheses. I'll tell you about this. So to create the function, basically we can type def, then we can type function name. So here function name is hello function, and then parentheses, and we can end the function by using the semicolon sign. Okay, so here we had already defined the function, right? So what is the function, what is the work of this function is to print hello world. So whenever we use this function, whenever we'll be calling this function, we'll be getting the output as hello world. Okay, so to call the function, you can use the function name and parentheses. So here the function name is hello function. So to call the function, we can use hello function and the parentheses. So it will give you the output as hello world that we have already defined to our function. Okay, so now we'll check the return type function. The function that return value. Okay, these are return type functions are basically the functions that return value. A return statement is used to end the execution of the function call and returns the result value of expressing false. Okay, so basically guys, value of expression following the return keyword to the caller. Okay, so the statement after the return statements are not executed. So if we'll give any kind of statements after the return statement, that will not be executed inside the function. So we'll understand this here. And the main thing here guys, if the return statement is without any expression. So here the main thing is that with return statement, we need to give any expression. If we'll not provide any expression, then the special value none is returned. Okay, so it will return you the value as none. Okay, so this is the syntax def. As I already told you that to define the function, we need to use def, then function name and parentheses. For example, here we'll define the function. Okay, so to define the function, we have used def. Then this is a function name add. You can use any name as per your wish. So basically these are the parameters guys. Whatever the value will be giving inside the parentheses, that is parameter. So here parameter is a comma b. Then we'll close, we will end this function by using the semicolon sign for indentation. Okay, and what we need, and after defining the function, what we need to return, we need the output of output sum of a and b. Okay, so for that we can use the return function. So return a plus b. Okay, so it means whenever we'll be using this function, so we have defined this function, we will be returning a plus b. Okay, same another example is def is true is function name, then parenthesis, inside the parenthesis a is a parameter, then semicolon to end the function. Here we'll return the bool a. Bool means the boolean type is basically the boolean data type is true or false. It will return you the value as true or false. Okay, now we'll be calling the function. So if we'll be calling this function, that is add a b. Okay, this is the variable we have used. There is, as a result, you can use any variable guys. So this is a res for result is equal to add 2 and 3. Here we have defined the value of a. Okay, we have defined the value of a and b, a as 2 and b as 3. So it will return you the value of sum of a and b. Okay, so here we use print result of add function is this curly bracket we have used for the output. Okay, that will contain the output dot format result. So this result RES will include this whatever we define to our variable RES. Okay, so basically it will return you the value of A and B. We have defined A as 2 and B as 3. Okay, so it will return you the value as 5. So this is how we can create the function or we can call the function. Okay, so I hope this video was useful for you. Okay, in this video we learn about the built-in function, the module function, the mathematical function and the user-defined function. Okay, thank you so much for your time.